So what you were just watching there was, I have this Japanese saw, which cuts on the pulse stroke, and it has a 22 thou kerf. So I'm cleaning out these slots so that I have enough depth before I level and correct the fingerboard. I want to make sure we got enough depth for the frets. So this saw comes to a point on one side, is rounded on the other. So the pointed side allows me to get right in tight to the binding, and I can push with this hand, pull with my arm to make sure we clean that out. When I flip it, the rounded part just kind of gets the center of the fret slot. That's what you were just watching me do. So now I know that the depth of all of these fret slots allows enough real estate for me to correct the fingerboard, and that's what we're about to do now. So I've taken a tracing off of that arch, and this is what I'm using to verify the fingerboard. So I'm going to true the fingerboard up. I have loaded the truss rod slightly, ever so slightly. So I'm going to true the fingerboard up for that radius and make sure that along the trajectory of the string path that it's dead straight, and I'll check that with a straight edge before we put those new frets in. This is the sculpted bridge that the customer ordered from the States, this true arc bridge. No. So I machined off the bottom half and buffed it out in order to bring the action down to where we needed it. Now the posts were a little thin and the bridge was kind of wobbling on the posts, so I did wrap the posts and then put some heat shrink to pull the wrap in tight to give us a good press fit.